So welcome to the third part of the sliding contact bearing. So now we will solve few numericals on the design of sliding contact bearing by Raimondi and Boyd method. So first we will see one numerical here. The following data is given for a 360 degree hydrodynamic bearing. So the radial load that is to be carried by this bearing is 3.2 kN. The journal rotating at a speed of 1490 rpm. The radial clearance given for this bearing is 0.05 mm. Viscosity of lubricant is 25 centipoise. Then the journal diameter is 50 mm and bearing length is 50 mm. It means it is actually the square bearing. 50 by 50 mm is length, 50 mm is diameter. So it is a square bearing. Now assuming a total heat generated on the bearing is carried by the total oil flow in the bearing, calculate. So they are asking us to calculate these different parameters. Assuming that the heat generated in the bearing is being carried away by the total oil flow in the bearing. So first you have to find out the coefficient of friction, then we have to find out the power lost in friction, then we have to find out the minimum oil film thickness of that bearing, then you have to find out the flow requirement in liters per minute of this bearing and the temperature rise in the bearing. So these are the things that you have to find out. So let us start first. So we are going to specify the given data, that is W means load carrying capacity is given to you, journal speed is given to you. So diameter and length of the bearing is given to you, then clearance C 0.05, yes, this centipoise 25 centipoise. Okay, so first step to be followed in solving this numerical is to calculate the performance parameters. So the performance parameters which we can calculate from the given data, which is possible for us to calculate, that is pressure. So force per unit projected area will give us the pressure. So force is available to us, and for calculating the projected area we are having the dimensions L and T. So it is 3.2 × 10³ in newtons the force, and 50 by 50 is the area, projected area. So you will get 1.28 N/mm² as a pressure. Then we will find out the Sommerfeld number, that is S. So it is given by R by C bracket square into mu into NS by P. So R is nothing but 25, because radius of the journal, because as the diameter is 50 mm, so radius will be 25 mm, and C is 0.05 radial clearance, R by C bracket square, that into mu 25 divided by 10⁻⁹, because this is in Newton second per mm² value of viscosity. 21490 is the RPM, revolutions per minute, divided by 60, so it will be in revolutions per second. And P, small p, that is pressure intensity, just now we have got this is 1.28, so it is 1 by 1.28. So we will get this multiplication as 0.121. Similarly, now the third parameter, that is L by D ratio, we will calculate. So L by D ratio is equal to 50 by 50, that is length is 50 and diameter is 50, so you will get it as a 1. Now with the use of these three parameters, we will make use of the table in which you will get all these other values of the dimensionless parameters. So like here is the data available for L by D ratio equal to 1. This is the value of epsilon, this is the value of HO by C, this is Sommerfeld number, this is phi, this is R by C into F, this is Q by RC NSL, this is QS by Q, and this is P by P max. Now what is our value of Sommerfeld number? That is 0.121. And what is the L by D ratio? That is 1. So this is L by D ratio 1, so I will be referring to this data. And from here Sommerfeld number is nothing but 0.121, and third figure was the pressure 1.28. so we have used this pressure for finding out the Sommerfeld number only. So now corresponding to this Sommerfeld number 0.121, I will note down all those values, this epsilon value, this is HO by C 0.4, this phi value, this R by C into F 3.22, Q by RC NSL 4.33, Q S by Q 0.680, and P by P max. It means I am going to follow this particular row corresponding to the value of 0.121. And the same you can see here, those values are written here. L by ratio 1, this S 0.121, R by 73.22, HO by C 0.4, Q by R sin result 4.33. Now whatever the values I have to get, accordingly I will make use of those data. So first, now second step is to calculate the coefficient of friction. So coefficient of friction, as I have got the value of R by C into F, so F will be equal to 3.22 into C by R. So 3.22 multiplied by C divided by R, so I will get this value as 0.00644. Next step is to find out the power lost in friction. Now we know the power lost in friction equation is 2 pi ns by 10 to 6 into FWR. So this is torque and omega. So we will get the power. So 2 pi ns is 21490 by 60 multiplied by F value, which is calculated from here. Then W value, which is given value, okay, and R value, that is 25 divided by 10 to 6. You will get power lost in friction as 0.08. Now next is minimum oil film thickness. So HO by C value we have got, that is 0.4 from the table. So HO will be equal to 0.4 into C. So C is already available to us. This is multiplied by 0.4, you will get 0.02 mm. Next is to find out the flow requirement in liters per minute. So Q by RC and SL, that value we have noted as 4.33, this value. So Q will be equal to 4.33 multiplied by RC into NS into L. So I just have to put the value of R 25, C 0.05, NS 1490 by 60 and L is 50. So I will get this 6720.5 mm cube per second. That is what is to be converted into, by multiplying it by 10 raised to minus 3, it will be in cubic centimeter per second. And then finally I wanted it in terms of liters per minute. So again it will be multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3, and to convert into in minutes, it is multiplied by 60. So this 6720.5 multiplied by 10 raised to 3 multiplied by 10 raised to 3 and this 60. So it is liters per minute. Okay. So finally Q will be equal to 0.403 liter per minute. Now last this step, next step is to go for the temperature rise. So temperature rise, delta T is given by 8.3 into P into CFE by FE. So CFE value is 3.22 and FE value is 4.33 and pressure is 1.28. So if I put these values, I will get this delta T, which is equal to 7.9 degrees Celsius. So that is what this is, what the total problem is being solved in these different steps, and we have got all the required values from coefficient of friction to the temperature right at the end. Now we will see one more numerical in which the given data is like this. So again here it is a 360 degree hydrodynamic bearing, and the radial load carrying capacity is 10 kN. General speed is 1440 rpm. Unit bearing pressure 1000 kilopascal. Clearance ratio is given, R by C, that is 800. Viscosity is 30 mini pascal second, that is 30 into 10 raised to minus 3 mega pascal second. So assuming that here also the heat generated in the bearing is carried by the total oil flow in the bearing, we are supposed to calculate the dimensions of the bearing, because here length and diameter of the bearing is not specified, so that you have to calculate here. Then coefficient of friction you have to find out, power loss in friction, total oil flow of oil, side leakage, temperature rise, average temperature, and when the inlet temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, and also find the maximum pressure. Means here more number of parameters are asked to find out. So let us start for the solution of this. So as they have specified the pressure, so pressure we can write it as 1000 into 10 raised to 3 pascal, so 10 raised to 6 into 10 raised to minus 6 newton per mm square. That is the nothing but a conversion to get that particular pressure into mega pascal. So you will find out that this is 1 mega pascal. Now length and diameter, if you have to find out, because this is pressure is equal to force upon area. So area is taken on this side and force upon area. So this pressure is decided to us, that is this area. So given radial load is 10 into 10 to 3 newton, that means 10,000 newton, and now the pressure is 1 megapascal. So the ratio of force by pressure becomes 10,000 divided by 1, so it will be nothing but the area. Now this area is the product of L and D. Now here we have to assume the L by D ratio. So if you assume L by D ratio equal to 1, then we will get the dimension of this length and the diameter. So length will be equal to 100 mm and the diameter will be also equal to 100 mm. After getting this, now we will find out the Sommerfeld number, that is R by C bracket square into mu into ns by p. So R by C value is given as 800, so it's square multiplied by mu value, that is 30 into 10 raised to minus 9, and ns is 1440 divided by 60 divided by p, so pressure is 1 megapascal. So finally you are getting the value of s as 0.4608. Now we will move to the next step. Now for L by D ratio equal to 1 and Sommerfeld number equal to 0.4608, we have to find out the values from the table. Now we know that in the table the value may not be available exactly for Sommerfeld number of 0.4608. So therefore we have to find out the value of the different dimensionless parameters corresponding to this value of L by D ratio equal to 1 and Sommerfeld number 0.4608 by using interpolation. So we will find out that the Sommerfeld number lies between 0.264 to 0.631. That is, this value of the Sommerfeld number will lie between these two values. So corresponding to this, the value of R by C into F is 5.79, means value of R by C into F corresponding to 0.264 is 5.79 and corresponding to 0.631 is 12.8. And we are interested in finding the value of this R by CF corresponding to the Sommerfeld number value of 0.4608. So I am using this similarity of triangles here to find out the value of this R by C into F. So this R by C into F minus 5.79, means height of this particular triangle, divided by 0.4608, means length of this triangle, minus 0.264. So this vertical height of this triangle divided by the length of this triangle. Similarly, now height of this triangle, bigger triangle, that is 12.8 minus 5.79, which is written over here, divided by 0.3631, this one and this one. So this is for the bigger triangle, these three points we have to concentrate. Now from this, now I have to find out the value of R by C into F. So what I will do is, I have written this particular term here, and just doing the simplification to get the value of R by C into F, and which I am getting it as 9.55. Now similarly we have to find out the other value of the dimensionless parameters corresponding to this Sommerfeld number of 0.4608. This is the Sommerfeld number 4608, which will again lie between 0.264 to 0.631, and corresponding values of Q by RC and SL are 3.59 and 3.99. So here also I am going to use the similarity of triangle. So I have this smaller triangle and this is a larger triangle. So this minus this I will write, divided by this minus this, and similarly this minus this divided by this value of x and this value of x. So accordingly I am getting the Q by RC and SL value as 3.78. After that, QS by Q, that value I will find out. So that I am getting it as, again by interpolation, it is 0.38. Now once I get all these values, then I will try to find out my first parameter which is required to be calculated. So coefficient of friction. So as I have calculated the R by C into F values, this is, I got 9.55. So F will be equal to 9.55 multiplied by C by R. So if I put the value of this C by R, I will get this value of coefficient of friction. Similarly, the power loss in friction will be calculated by using our expression of PF, in which I have to put the value of 2 pi ns into, this is the value of F, this is the value of W, this is the value of R, 50 divided by 10 to 6. So I will get power loss in friction as 0.9. Then I will calculate the total oil flow of the oil, so using Q by RC and SL. So Q by RC and SL value I have got, that is 3.78 multiplied by this RC and SL. So I will get the value of Q, which is 28350 mm3 per second. Then if I have to get the side leakage, so QS by Q I have got the value as 0.38. So QS will be equal to 0.38 into Q. So I will get it as 1073.7 773 mm cube per second. Then I will find out the temperature rise. Delta T is equal to 8.3 P into CFE by FE. So again I am putting the value of CFE and FE here and value of pressure. So I am getting this temperature rise as 22.97 degrees Celsius. And then if I have to find out the average temperature of lubricating oil, then average temperature is initial temperature plus this delta T by 2. So 40 is given as an inlet temperature of the oil. So 40 plus 22.97 divided by 2, it is 51.48 degrees Celsius. So this is what is the end of this particular numerical. In this, we have got all the values. We calculate all the values which are required for this numerical to complete. So we started from dimensions of bearing by the considering the square bearing. Then we found out the coefficient of friction, power loss in friction, total power of oil, side leakage, temperature rise, average temperature, and finally maximum pressure. So in this way, we can say that we have come to the end of this unit in short, and we got a sufficient idea to solve the numericals of this kind. Thank you very much.